British making white breaking.
Thank you.
I will elaborate on my experience of his work as a Jew. For those who do not know, care hunting was a euphemism for killing Jews by the Gestapo during the Holocaust headquarters. The Nazi judgment that all Jews ought to be exterminated. Beuys was busy with reconstruction of Germania and holding us, the Jews, as a dead hare. The question should be different. In my opinion, Beuys only cared about his own wounds.
Beuys never confessed to his Nazi past.
It surprised me that Joseph Beuys didn't do a confession about his involvement with the Nazi army. I wanted to criticize that.
In 1936, Beuys was a member of the Hitler Youth.
I know that it was compulsory. But actually, later on, in 1941, Beuys volunteered for the Luftwaffe Air Force. In 1942, Beuys was stationed in Crimea and was a member of various combat bomber units. He actually volunteered. Nobody asked him.
He dropped bombs on innocent people.
In his brilliant way, Beuys transformed his subjectivity to the suffering of the German soldier in the Second World War. In that odd way, Beuys became a victim. He transformed himself from a victimizer to a victim. I don't really trust this social order he created.
In my performance in Amsterdam,
I sat on an aluminum office cabinet with a chair that belonged to a Gestapo waiting room in Berlin. I had a wine glass on the window.
The neon light under my chair.
In between copper plates I had a talit, a Jewish prayer shawl. I was holding a hare which I cast from bronze. One of the code words of the Nazi Wehrmacht was, Jag den Hasen, hunt a rabbit. And they meant, we are going to hunt the Jews. Beuys could have chosen any other animal. But of course, he chose the hare. He walked with the dead rabbit into the gallery, where he did the performance and explained to him the paintings that he did with his own blood in a language that nobody understood. I concluded that he tried to speak with the hare in Hebrew. I converted Beuys to Judaism. In one hand, I was holding the rabbit and the other was placed on my forehead to symbolize pain and at the same time deep thinking. There was a neon light on the wall, symbolizing God's eternal light that answers the cross that was underneath the chair and the wine glass, symbolizing the crucifixion of Jesus Christ.
I met him twice. Once in Berlin, at the National Gallery.
It sounds like I have a love-hate relationship with him. On one hand, so many of my artworks are in dialogue with his art. On the other hand, I can't stand the position that he took as a victimizer in German and European art. In 1982, I wrote a letter to Albrecht Dürer and explained to him my thoughts on Luther and Beuys. In his ironic way, Beuys would have rejected me. He did already with the hare, holding me, a dead Jew, in his hands. Well, I am a Babylonian Jew and I don't succumb to all of the construction of silence around Beuys. Joseph Sassoon Semah. Beuys was a soldier who returned from war and starting to create through his personal pain. He transformed himself from a victimizer to a victim.
I don't really trust this social order he created. Of course.
It is not only about the Germans. It is about Western ideology. And it affects the whole cultural world, including the works of Beuys. Well, I am a Babylonian Jew and I don't succumb to all of the construction of silence around Beuys.
I am free from it.
I can read it in a totally new way. It took me time.